really deep voice. Now that you mention it, the girl's the only fucking took a number. Hey, did you see the size of her hand? Yeah. Holy shit! Oh, listening to your crap almost made me miss it.
Dude, don't. Don't!
What are you, crazy man? I'm hammered drunk. If I don't remember stealing this car, it probably didn't happen, right? Right from the get-go, something's not right here. First, I think we'll talk about some of the movie's good points. There really are some pretty cool cars in this movie. Possibly the coolest Woody station wagon ever seen in a movie. Also, an amazing suicide door Lincoln. Okay, something's really not right here. One cherry-looking 71 Charger. Yeah, we saw another one of these in a previous movie I discussed. Only that one was a 73 model with a sledgehammer nose job. Now, on to the rest of the movie. After being smashed in a traffic accident, the car is taken to a local towing lot. The car quickly comes back to life and repairs itself, morphs into a pickup truck, and goes looking for dinner. The garage is run by this guy Ray, a total moron played by an actor who can't even deliver his lines properly. After the office is trashed, Ray reveals that the key to the main door was in there, and it's now lost in the wreckage. So it's a shame that Ray had to go and lock down the main garage door, as it is the only way in or out of the building. Yeah, there were other doors to the building, but Ray the rocket scientist had them welded shut to avoid break-ins. It seems to me that the filmmakers took all the best elements of the killer car genre and threw them out the window, replacing them with shitty acting and the same tired plot we've seen in every Monster of the Week movie since the beginning of history. That was mistake number one. Mistake number two. Revealing the evil that is powering the car, doing it way too early in the movie, and having it be something as ridiculous as this. So what we're really dealing with here is actually a badly rendered CGI shape-shifting snake monster disguising itself as a car. Mistake number three. Not enough of this. Action. The shapeshifter spends much of the movie aimlessly wandering around the parking garage. If you're gonna make a movie revolve around an automobile, or in this case a shapeshifter disguising itself as one, you need to have that thing crashing into stuff, revving up the engine, spinning tire, running people down. We do get a little bit of that, but not nearly enough for the price of admission. Well, to make a long story short, they do end up faking out the demon where it falls into a pit trap lined with spikes that they built in the elevator shaft, and this should have killed the girl too.
Look at the size of that CGI monster! Boy, he looks pissed!
Well, it was damn lucky this other car was randomly hanging its ass over the shaft. Maybe it was taking a dump?
How do we get out of here?
Ray, you testicle gargling butt plug, you had the friggin' key in your pocket the whole damn time. Your lucky girlfriend's gonna be glad to get out of here, or else she'd be castrating you with her dirty fingernails. That might have made for a decent ending. So, as Girlie leaves the garage, she's suddenly passed by a bunch of identical black Dodge Magnums heading for the garage. Meanwhile, Ray is calling the local news desk to sell his story.
Channel 1 News.
Before realizing he's not alone. His fate remains unknown, but clearly this sets the stage for a sequel. And if a sequel does get made, rest assured I will rip on it for your amusement.
Make poop. Everybody in the club wanna make poop. Everybody in their car wanna make poop. Everybody going on a date, make poop. Everybody running late, just make poop.